Hey y'all. So Zach here with Tech for Lawyers, back again with another Tech Tips Tuesday. And today we're going to talk about Google Docs and Google Drive a little bit, but specifically I want to talk about version control in Google Docs. Now, version control for lawyers, obviously it helps you stay more organized. It helps with the sharing of documents. It helps you know, what the current working document is. And a lot of us have gotten used to, just naming our documents something new and dating the documents, putting draft and final, and no, seriously, this time this is final, just added on to the end of the document. And it can get confusing as to what the current working document is. And even if you're sharing it and you're having multiple people edit it at the same time, it is difficult to know which one to be working in. So Microsoft Word and Google Docs have actually added features that'll help you organize this. So what we're talking about is making those changes, making those versions, and keeping them within one document, and then being able to see the changes that have happened between version one, version two, draft, second draft, final draft, and all of that. So I'm going to show you that very quickly, and it's pretty simple in Google Docs, frankly. In order to start, though, we've got a Google document up. It's an untitled document because it's new. And in order to start doing the version control, we need to title this. So we're going to call this Tech Tips Tuesday Example because, frankly, that's exactly what it is. In order to start doing our versions, though, we're going to go to Version History. And we're going to name this current version. We're going to call it original because my naming conventions are exactly that. They are original. We're going to go in and make some changes in order to show what happens when we do that. So we're going to do heading one. Heading two. You guessed it. Heading three. And we've got just some example information. So now we're going to pretend like I actually spent a lot of time on this, and this is draft one. So we're going to go up, we're going to hit File, Version History, Name Current Version. Now I'm going to call this version two, and we're going to call it draft because that's how my naming conventions go. So we're going to save that. And now we've got an original and we've got a draft. But in order to show you that, File, Version History, and then see Version History. Now, at the same time, you could just hit Control Alt Shift H. But frankly, that's actually more difficult than just going to File Version History and clicking on See Version History. So on the right-hand side, there's a column that is your version history. And as you can see, we're on version 2 draft. And these green highlighted things are the changes that have been made since the previous version. And you can also see who made the changes. Since I'm the only one working on this, you'll see just Zach Glazer. But if there was somebody else in here and they were making changes, you would be able to see what changes they made as opposed to what changes I made. But we can go back to the original and we can see that it's a blank document. We go to version two and we can see that all these changes were made. It is an amazing piece of writing and we're gonna hang on to it. So we're gonna go back to version two, to the working version. And even though it's an amazing piece of writing, we're going to make a few changes just to show you what happens when we do that. We're going to do information that does matter. Then we're going to do some italicized information. A whole new paragraph. So now we're going to go in, since we've made some significant changes, we're going to make it a new draft. Version history, name current version. And we're going to call this, you know, maybe version 3. And since it's still a draft, we'll keep it a draft. Hit save, and now we've got a version 3. In order to show you that, again, file, version history, see version history. And on the right-hand side, as you can see, we've got original. We've got version 2. And again, we see the changes between version 2 and original. And then we have version 3, and we can see the changes between version 3 and version 2. If we don't want to see those changes, we can actually uncheck this box down here on the right-hand side, and it'll show us a clean version. But Google's going to go ahead and track those changes for you one way or the other. So I like to see them. That's part of why I have this version control, is to see what changes I've made since a little bit previous. But that's it. We go back to our original here. And actually, I need to show you one more thing. So we're going to go to File, Version History, See Version History. And if we go to version 2 or original or the first version there, you can see in the upper left-hand corner, there's a restore this version. So if I had made significant changes in version 3 and then I just wanted to get rid of them completely, let's say I put in an entire chapter, a paragraph or clause or something like that, then I could revert back to a previous version and go from there, and we get rid of all those changes that were made. I like this when I'm talking about, you know, major changes to a document, when I do a lot of editing. Sometimes I'll just go ahead and, you know, lean into some major editing that I do, knowing that I can get back to the previous version pretty quickly. So we'll get out of that. And that's it. That is version control for Google. There is a lot you can do with that, and I particularly like it when you share documents with other users, because you can see the changes that they made. But the biggest thing is that you can keep one single working document, and then you can save the versions within that. So take those naming conventions that you already use. Take the version 1, put a date on it, and then put draft, and do that within the document. This just puts it all in the same place under one document, and you can have a working document for everybody. So I hope that speeds you up. But more importantly, I hope that organizes you a little. Thank you for watching this latest Tech Tip Tuesday, and have a good rest of your day.